And the fact that they're still good was my reason for holding on to them. But that should also be my reason for letting them go and letting someone else use them while they still have something to offer. Greetings, fellow human. I'm Rose from happyandauthentic.com. And today I am going to talk to you a little bit about my decluttering process. This morning I spent a lot of time decluttering my junk drawers. And yes, I do eventually accumulate junk in my drawers when I'm in a hurry or my partner's in a hurry. We just kind of throw stuff in the drawers and we fully intend to come back to it and fix it up later. And then we just kind of forget. So I went through a whole bunch of the drawers here in this office and I found notebooks, you know, the empty ones that are lined or not lined that I am very guilty of purchasing, writing a little bit in, and then forgetting, and then buying new ones. So I scanned all of the things in those notebooks, took out the used pages, and now I'm gonna try to give them to somebody else. I know a few people that might need them. I mean, I'm a teacher, so I can definitely give them to either the kids or the other teachers at school. Now that's made a whole bunch of space here in my bookcase, then I started tackling the drawers. And oh my god, were these cluttered! There was actual rubbish in here. As a relief teacher, I photocopy a lot of things when I need to go to a class, and sometimes they don't get used, or sometimes I just have a lot of extra. And because I feel really bad about wastage in that area, I bring it home. Then it just becomes obvious that I'm not going to use it again. So I've decided I made a huge pile and I'm going to take it to the next kindergarten or preschool class that I go to and they can use it as scrap paper to draw on. So yeah, holding onto them was kind of silly. I'm gonna take them all away and use them for something that I know they can be used for, even if it's not their original intended purpose. Another thing that happened was I found a bunch of books that I have read and will never read again, and I'm just going to try to let them go. So these ones are books that I have enjoyed and loved, but I'm not going to read a fictional story again. So I'm going to take them to my local bookstore that has a policy of giving you store credit if they think they can resell your books and they're in good condition. That way I can get other books at a cheaper price. So that's what they're destined for. These books here are books that I have kind of decided probably won't be resold. It's a little bit harder to get people to buy them at the bookstore, so I'm just putting them up for free on Marketplace. A few different online marketplaces, actually. Anyway, so once these books find a new home, I will have more space. Not that, you know, right now they're not in the way. I literally have nothing else other than, you know, what is this? Some random little bits and bobs on my desk, so it's not like they're in the way. Anyways, another thing that I did was clean out my bedside table, which was notorious for being just covered in random rubbish. And now I have so much space that the one down the bottom is basically empty. There's practically nothing in here. Just a small umbrella, a little torch, some perfume. I don't really have a special space for a lot of these things in the house, so they just kind of get put here. Same with these things. There's lighting for my videos. This is my earphones, a solar charger, and you know, little things that now that are easier to find because before it was just a mess in there. Anyway, the reason why I'm telling you guys all this is because I know it's really hard to find the time to declutter and do something like this. Normally, I would just go about my day and do other things like run errands, cook, make videos like this, and I convinced myself that I just didn't have time to declutter. But it really didn't take that long. I did a whole bunch of decluttering and scanning in less than an hour. And if I would had been more thorough, maybe 2 hours. Now I still have my whole day free, and 2 hours is not a lot of time to spend on something that's that important. And to me, it's super important to not hold on to clutter. And some things are really hard to designate as clutter, like books that are clearly still in perfect condition. For me, they're clutter because I'm not using them. They just sat there in my office for years. I've had those for years. And the fact that they're still good was my reason for holding on to them. But that should also be my reason for letting them go and letting someone else use them while they still have something to offer. Because if they get too old, a lot of those things just can't be used anymore. Especially things that get updated as science progresses in those areas. I also found this, which is a sleeping mat for camping. I haven't used this, it's been like 7 years. I used this once, because since then I have been using a bigger one. This one I had when I was single, and when I met my partner, it was useless. So that's going up for sale as well. I feel better when I know I'm not holding on to these things. There's our picture. You see the resemblance? I just wanted to let you guys know that it's okay to take a little bit of time where you can. And it doesn't have to be something that other people see and appreciate or even understand. I probably will get a lot of flack for not showing you as I decluttered, or maybe not. You guys are really nice. I really enjoy talking to you guys and sharing my life with you guys because you're so accepting and lovely. Anyway, here's a couple more things that I've been putting up for sale. Some little USB flash drives that I found, and this is SD cards and the SD card reader, because I don't use them anymore. Someone can get more use out of them than me. I don't really have anything else to say. I'm going to go back to trying to figure out if there's anything else I need to declutter, and then I'll probably get back to my everyday routine. If you guys have anything you want to discuss about decluttering, let me know. Say it in the comments down below. I'm always really interested to hear what you guys think and what you guys do. So if you have your own version of decluttering that might be helpful to me or to other people, let us know. That's what the comments are for. I hope that you found this video enlightening and useful. If you did, give it a like. Subscribe if you want to watch more videos from me. I make a new one every single Sunday. And if you want to support the channel in a more monetary way, there's also Patreon. I have a few different perks there that also include discounts for my minimalist and relationship programs, which you might find useful if that's the sort of thing you're interested in. But yeah, whatever you decide. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you when I see you. And of course, I would love to thank my beautiful and lovely patrons, Eric Gindes, Anne Marie Sands, Don Rivers, Liz Mar Santiago, Lauren McKenzie, Tanya Danilenko, and Tim Farness. Thank you so much, you guys. I really appreciate all of your help, the fact that you've been here for me for so long, and the fact that you're just so kind and generous and interesting to talk to. So I'll see you guys over there soon. So I will see you guys over there really soon. Thanks again.